Welcome to your most favorite channel, Heartbeat. My name is Dr. Amrit Kejriwal. This channel is mainly meant for MBBS students, postgraduates, medical professionals, and all those who may find it a bit more easy. It is an attempt to make the complicated medical sciences more simplified and easier for understanding. Today we'll learn something about Subclavian-Steel syndrome. Channel's name is Heartbeat. My name is Dr. Amrit Kejriwal. Subclavian-Steel syndrome. It's characterized by retrograde blood flow in the subclavian artery. Now coming to the anatomy. The circle of Willis. It is formed by two internal carotid arteries and two vertebral arteries. The internal carotid artery is a branch of the common carotid artery. The right common carotid artery is a branch of the brachiocephalic trunk and left side is the branch of arch of aorta. Vertebral arteries are branches of the second part of the subclavian arteries. Now coming to the basic pathology. Narrowing of the subclavian artery proximal to the vertebral artery exists. And there's retrograde blood flow in the vertebral artery. And blood flow to the brain is stolen by the subclavian artery, which is responsible for the neurological symptoms. The etiology commonly is atherosclerosis. Other common causes include the cervical rib and Takayasu's arthritis. There are many other causes, but I have not enumerated all of them. Coming to the anatomy, here you can see the arch of aorta. This is the brachiocephalic trunk and this is the subclavian artery originating from the brachiocephalic trunk on the right side, and left side is the subclavian artery which originates from the arch of aorta. This is the continuation of the subclavian artery. These two are the common carotid arteries. Common carotid artery on the right side is a branch of the brachiocephalic trunk and the left side originates directly from the arch of aorta. These are the two internal carotid arteries. The dotted lines are the external carotid arteries. In this discussion, we will not be concerned much with them. That is why they are shown in dotted lines. And these are the vertebral arteries. The right one, you can see over here, the parallel lines, and the left one over here on the parallel lines. And the two vertebral arteries and the two common carotid arteries, they are anastomoses to form the circle of Willis. Now coming to the direction of blood flow. The arrows represent the direction of the blood flow in the arch of aorta, these arrows. These arrows show the direction of the blood flow in the right subclavian, right common carotid, left common carotid and left subclavian. This is the blood flow in the subclavian, direction of blood flow. Direction of blood flow in the internal carotid arteries, direction of blood flow in the external carotid arteries, and the direction of blood flow in the vertebral arteries. Now we are mainly concerned about this. Let us see what happens if a patient has left subclavian artery stenosis over here. We'll see that in the next diagram. Now this is the same diagram. The blood flow in this artery reduces over here. And so this thins out also. Just let us see this thins out. And blood from the brain is stolen by the subclavian artery, by the vertebral artery over here. So blood comes in this direction and blood flow is restored in the distal subclavian artery. So blood going to the brain is stolen by the subclavian artery over here. You can see the direction of the blood flow changes. Coming to the clinical features, patient with decreased blood supply of the brain can develop presyncope, syncope or neurological deficits. There can be differential pulse and blood pressure in the upper limbs. Patient may have memory problems. Upper limb shows signs of vascular insufficiency and exercise induced claudication in the upper limb of the affected side. Investigations done are Doppler ultrasound, सीटी एंजियोग्राफी, एमआरए एंजियोग्राफी, डिजिटल सब्ट्रैक्शन एंजियोग्राफी. फोर वेसल एंजियोग्राफी इज़ जनरली नॉट डन नाउडेज बिकॉज इट इज़ इनवेजिव, बट स्टिल इट इज़ अ प्रेशर टू सी द रेट्रोग्रेड ब्लड फ्लो इन द सबक्लेवियन आर्टरी एंड बींग डायग्नोस्ड. ट्रीटमेंट, नो सिम्टम्स नो ट्रीटमेंट, नो सिम्टम्स नो ट्रीटमेंट. सर्जिकल कैरोटिड सबक्लेवियन बाईपास, स्टेंट एंड बलून एंजियोप्लास्टी एंड आर्टरेक्टोमी वॉज डन इन द पास्ट, नाउ इट इज़ नो लॉन्गर डन.